this sefer I've been looking.
This is if you guys want me to get, I can get a bunch. We've done sichot from him before, Rabbi Tzvi Meir, Silberberg, Baruch Hashem. And I got it, I got it like 2 years ago, maybe a year and a half ago, and I opened it up on Shabbos. I'm like, why am I opening this up on Shabbos? So that's what I want to start doing, before Shabbos. And ideally, this should be a Sunday morning Chabura. Bemet, if we're being real.
If we do mornings, I'm a Friday.
Well, for now, we'll start with this. Now, the whole Hakdama here, I was like, no, I'm going to do the whole Hakdama. And I see that the Hakdama was written pretty fast before they printed the Sefer. And that's why 50 to 60% of it is in Yiddish. And I was cracking my trying so hard to figure this out. But then I realized, let's go to the first Sicha. We'll go jump right inside, because first of all, it's less Yiddish, and he covers a lot of things he says in the Hakdama. Rabbi Tzvi Meir Silberberg. He's, I don't know how to explain him. He's probably mid-50s. I don't know, I'm not sure exactly. Young, fire, very close to Rav Weinberg, fire. If you go, people from all over Eretz Yisrael go to hear him Shalosh Shudas. So how can you go hear him Shalosh Shudas? Because he goes off for hours after Shabbos. People go from all over the place. He's still in, you know.
Where is he sit?
Where is he good? Yerushalayim. We'll go. Yeah, we'll go, Bezrat Hashem. We were never there. But we've learned, do you remember one Kaidzman, we did a whole set of Sichot on Kav Zchut? That was him. Just Kav Zchut.
I'm not going right yet. One of the most beautiful Rahululas.
Yeah, you went?
I try to go every year.
Oh, wow.
I just didn't go last year. Every type of Jews there, Chabad, like, you don't have to say.
He's amazing.
It's
Rav Tzvi Meir. He's amazing. Okay, let's go right inside. HaShabbat kolel kol haTorah. Shabbos includes the whole Torah. Yadua b'chazal ha-kdoshim she-shabbat kodesh hu kolel kol haTorah kula. Kedita bazor hakadosh, kegav nada shabbos iu klala deoraita, v'chol razin deoraita beit halyan. V'kiyuma de shabbos kekiyuma de chol oraita. Mandinati shabbos kilo nati oraisa kula. So basically he's saying that according to the Zohar HaKadosh, Shabbos is the klala deoraisa. It's the including of everything that's in the Torah. All the secrets of Torah are dependent on Shabbos. And when you keep Shabbos, it's as if you kept the whole Torah. So that people are like, okay, cool. So I'm just going to make sure I'm halachic, and I just keep Shabbos. Obviously, it's not with, it's the one level of what we're talking about. And whoever uproots Shabbos, it's as if they uprooted the whole Torah kula. Unevayel kama nekudot lemaise ba'avoda zo shel klal doraita hanogea lemaise. Now the beautiful thing here is that he's saying over here we're gonna mevaer, we're gonna help us with a few lemaise things. Like this is what did he say right now? He said a very big statement. But how does that help me lemaisa? Can anyone from what he just said right now say lemaisa? What does that mean? It's klalim, doraita, you know. Aval, we're here to do the avodah lemaisa. How does it work lemaisa? So he goes like this. This is beautiful. He's first going to speak really up here, and he's going to bring it down to the halacha as well. That's what I love about him. Ritzon avinu shebashamayim. What does Hashem want? Ha'inyan harishon hu lehagbia ulharem eta. 20 bucks for whoever can say the next word. Another 20 bucks for whoever can explain the next word. Sash, there's chairs here. Ritzon avinu shebashamayim. Hashem's ritzon is what? That we will lehagbia ulerohem eta tzugan. I think it means gaze. I bet. The way you look at things. He wants us to elevate the way we look by istaklut lechol prat uzman va'avoda shel Shabbos Kodesh. This is the key. He's saying over here so beautifully, the Ratzon of Hashem is for us to elevate the way we look at, like right now, when we look at Shabbos, so what's in our mind? So he's going to go through all the different zmanim of Shabbos, but like what's Shabbos? So I know I do this, I know I do that. Hopefully it'll be special, hopefully it'll be beautiful. What does it mean to lift up your gaze, to lift up the way you look at something? What does that mean, Lemaisa? How do you explain that to somebody? How do you lift up your histaklut al mashu? Like we talk about it all the time, about Eretz Yisrael, the fact that we're here. Le'arim et ha'histaklut, like lift up the way that you understand.
It's conscious, no?
Raise it, raise it up. Yeah,
what glasses are you going to look through?
Look, yeah. That's my... I'm going to look at everything. What do they say through Right, it's rose colored glasses now. It's Chelet colored glasses. Between Meir and
Silberberg. You
were
wearing from
now? Huh?
You were wearing
Chelet from now? From the Shabbos, yeah. From the Shabbos. My tzitzis and my talus. I just picked it up. Yeah. He did it for me. So, raising up the way that I look at the opportunity. That's the word I would say, the opportunity for Shabbos. Okay? Kvi shechazal hakadosh, the way chazal, that's lucky, time to go around.
David, come around.
Kvi shechazal hakadosh, v'rashbi bifrat, he's going to bring, it's not time we're learning this, that Rabbi Shimon is going to be very central here, that Rashbi explains, mevarim sheyesh bechina shel tevat noach shemitgale al yedei ha-shabbat. There's an aspect of an ark of Noach that becomes revealed through Shabbos. This is beautiful. Like he's going to show how if we understand the opportunity of Shabbos, it could be like building a place where you can go in and you're protected from everything in the world. אפשר גם לפרש את המילה תיבה, לא רק בתור תיבה, like an ark, אבל אפשר גם כמו בשם טוב, מילה, a word. Like you can go into the words of Shabbos, the word Shabbat, you can go into it as well. נוח מלשון מנוחה. Noach, obviously, why is Noach the Bechina of Shabbos? Because Noach means rest. Shabbos Kodesh, hu arei ha-shoresh shel kol Bechinat ha-menucha. Now, this is interesting. I could speak about myself, and I'm sure others can admit. Unfortunately, sometimes the most exhausted I ever am is after Shabbos. That means there's something off with my Shabbos. Because even if I'm doing the Avodah, and I'm not sleeping for God knows how many hours, if I'm doing it right, if I magubia, if I lift the way that I approach Shabbos, אני אמור להרגיש משהו יותר מרגיע בפנים. I should be feeling something more calming, even if I'm physically exhausted. I'm talking about nefesh-wise.
It's like when if you go for a good run, the adrenaline starts going, and afterwards, you're not tired.
It's different.
You feel amazing.
Right. So it should be that if I'm doing it, if I lift up what Shabbos can be, I'm supposed to be experiencing things differently.
Wouldn't it be that you let go of all your worries of the week before Shabbos, and then after Shabbos comes out,
it comes back? And by, yeah. But if Shabbos was really Shabbos, then when it comes back, it meets a new me. And it doesn't weigh on me the way that it did before Shabbos.
And you're saying, l'chachila, we shouldn't have those worries.
Alevai, alevai. But the Chazal say, צריך להרגיש כאילו שמלאכתו עשויה לו. You're supposed to feel like...
ויחל.
זהו, גמרנו. שבס קודש הוא הרי השורש של כל בחינת המנוחה. בכל שבס בונה תיבה שמגנה על הנשמה של יהודי מכל מיני שטף מים רבים. Every Shabbos, I build an ark which protects over the soul of every Jew from all the שטף מים רבים. How do you say that?
From the flood.
Kad Ayil Shabta, Kol Dinin Mit Abrimina, like we say in Kegavna, or some of us say in Kegavna. Kmo Shesham Aita Avoda Shlema Shel Binyat Teva B'Meshech 120 Shana. Just like there, Noach spent 120 years building the ark. Ulechol Chelek Uprat B'Teva Haya Shi'ur V'Tzura Meduyeket. We know that, Dov, you could talk about this construction-wise, Every single piece of the teva was
engineered perfectly.
Every part of it. Now, if we're saying Shabbos is the same, we're building a teva. That means that every single piece of Shabbos gamken has to have midah meduyeket. We have to know what we're dealing with. V'chol prat me'elu haya gavoa me'al gavoa. V'alidei ha'shlemut shel kol zeh nif'al ha'tzala shel Noach v'chol ha'dorot v'chol ha'olam. Think about it. As much as we're not called Bnei Noach, we are not called Bnei Noach, we're called Bnei Avraham. If it wasn't for Noach, we wouldn't be here. So something about Noach and the Menucha that he worked on so intensely enabled the world to continue to exist. Be'emet, if you want your life to be able to continue to exist and be saved, then Shabbos, the Teva, has to be built properly. And he's going to help us build Shabbos. Mamash.
Livnot Shabbat. It's like very exciting.
Kmo chen bechol Shabbat v'Shabbat ish et zeh b'china. Every single Shabbos has this aspect. V'ahachana l'Shabbos Kodesh hi binyan ha-teva. Okay. You're not building the ark on Shabbos. That's the difference here. Shabbos is when you go into the teva. So don't say, listen, I'm going to kill myself all week. I know Shabbos is coming, right? I'll work. And just on Shabbos, I'll. That's not it either. The building and the tzurot meduyakot is Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday.
It's that Thursday night.
Alavai. We'll see how Hilchot Shabbat are mirrored in this way. Hilchot Shabbat, the way we learn Hilchot Shabbat, we were learning from Rav Melamed's way also. It's all about table set. Like, Aruch HaShulchan. Shulchan Aruch or not. When do you prepare the table or not? So if I want to have a teva sheyachola lachzik li ve'agen alai, if I want to have an ark that can protect me, so it's cute that we're getting together Friday morning. But really, but you know, it should be that from Sunday I'm thinking about
Hayom Yom Rishon.
B'Shabbos, nachon.
So Friday morning must be a chazar.
On Sunday morning.
Well, let's get there, Bezrat Hashem. You have a big aspiration. No, high aspirations.
I don't want to stop the Friday morning. I like this.
No, don't worry. We're all good. Okay, in America you work Friday morning, right? Everyone works Friday morning. So
in America I work, sure.
Right. But I didn't work Sunday. You work on Sunday.
Right.
Even in Israel they do.
Where?
Even in Israel they do.
Everybody works Friday morning.
Efrat's
an exception. But this could also happen Monday, Tuesday.
Exactly.
We said just our neighbor. No, Avi's here. Avi and Yuri are here, the 9-to-5ers. Wow. Okay. V'achana l'Shabbos Kodesh y'binyan ha'teva. Lakachat kol. Okay, so he says over here, look at the bottom to fourth line in this paragraph. Lakachat kol prat uprat shel Shabbos Kodesh ulehagbi'o. We're going to learn about every aspect of Shabbos, and hopefully, like you said in the beginning, Tzugan. We're going to lift up the way that we think about it, the way we look at it. Lichyot im ha'emet shel v'kidashto mikol hazmanim. Right? That's what he say about Shabbos. Shabbos was sanctified more than any other time. We're going to live with the truth of that statement. Shehevenu ma'amenucha v'kdusha I think it's twice, right? Oh, bet pamim, nachon. Shevenu amnucha v'kdusha. No, let's continue. We'll be clear. Shafilu yoter miyom kippur. That we see, and this is what he said in the Hagdama. Perush badavar. Let's see. Shevenu amnucha v'kdusha. Perush badavar. Shafilu yoter miyom kippur. Could be. Each one of these svarim has his own Rashi Tevot. You have to learn it for a few years, and then you'll get a new language.
Parrot bat.
Sure.
You have to get to it.
Palm de palm. Who knows? You know. I don't know. Pardes barimonim. I don't know. You can make him a million things. So he says.
Facebook.
David. All right, let's talk about Hagbaha. Let's talk about lifting up. How you look?
You're streaming straight on.
We're on here. Yes, it's amazing. So this he says over here, based on the pasuk v'kitashto mikol hazmanim Chazal Darshin, and this is hard for us to understand. Shabbos has more kedusha than even Yom Kippur. But how do we relate to that sentence? We don't understand what that means. Hopefully, we will. Shabbos is the day of the soul. We have to live with the day of the soul. V'avodah zo shayechet lekol echad ve'echad, kfi shesiper echad ha'chaverim, b'shem echad migdolei hador shlita, shenishar eize avodah u'matzav v'chadome. Sheita basvarim hakdoshim legabei Shabbos, v'shalu, ha'im hu chiyuv al kol echad, o shu rak avur mish b'emet nimtza b'darga hazot. So one of the people asked one of the Gdolei Hador, tell me this dibur about living a Yom HaDenishmatim. Is that shayach to the normal people? Or is that just for people that are holding court? Like this avodah that he's speaking about over here. Because it could be, you could just listen, our door, as long as you don't mechal Shabbat, you go to shul and you have tzedakah with your family, it should be enough. He's saying that he asked a certain Gadol Ador, he says, Mapitom, it's for every single. Analo, Shuchiyuv al kol echad ve'echad, Nimatse, b'Shabbat Kodesh, b'kaze matzav merumam, b'gavoa, b'ofen sheziye shayach lo. Haynu shekol echad yachol liyot b'matzav gavoa u'merumam kfi madregato. Saying basically, each person has to go up. You got to lift it up a notch. Each person, Gdolim Ktanim has to look at the Pratim of Shabbos and lift it up a notch. Ba'inyan ha'sheni b'chlal doraita hu, shekol chelek uprat b'chlal avodat Hashem b'meshech yom ha'shabbat, yeh b'chizuk gadol u'be'ofen sheyesh shoresh lehagbiya et kol avodat Hashem b'chol ha'shavu haba. So this is a very interesting way of looking at Shabbos. Shabbos is either I'm running towards Shabbos, and Shabbos is the end game, or I view Shabbos, I shouldn't say or, according to this, it's and I view Shabbos as the gateway into next week. It's not or. It's Michlalo. He's saying it's the it's too close. It's duality. Legamre. It's I am marching towards. I'm building a teva all week towards. But really, I'm also like the fact that you and I are able to breathe now and get into something. Whatever it must be, because we say on Shabbos, Tchila leMikra'e Kodesh. Stomeret. Whatever is going to be a Mikra Kodesh in your week, whatever moment of Kedusha that you're going to have an opportunity of during the week, it's because it's coming from Shabbos. Tchilal Mikra'i Kodesh. So if I think of it like that, stop for a second, and I look at next week. Okay, I know I have to live in the now, v'chulei, but we're all into Hachanas all the time. All of us are neurotic. Some of us more than others. I say to myself, I want to make sure, Bezrat Hashem, that next week, whatever is going on in the world, I want it to be higher. I want to take more advantage of things. So this is coming to tell us, well, okay, that's beautiful. It's great you have a ratzon. But Tchilal Mikra'i Kodesh, what's your Shabbos going to be like? Are you going to lift up the different, he's going to say over here, that he's going to say there's 11 different zmanim of Shabbat. Look at every single one of them and say, where can I lift it up a notch? How can I look at it better? How can I approach it deeper? ובעזרת השם יתברך נדבר. By the way, you realize I'm going much faster than usual with the Hebrew, okay? But if it's something's a little bit difficult, just tell me. But I feel like we can. הגיע הזמן לרוץ יותר, okay? ובעזרת השם יתברך נדבר מהעניין הראשון שהזכרנו. We're going to speak about the first thing, not the next week, but the Hachana towards. That's what we're going to focus on. ואף שכל יחיד וציבור לפי מנהגו יש פרטים ואופנים שונים בזה. אכן באופן כללי נחלק את עבודת השבת ליוד א' זמנים. Yes, there are different ways you approach Shabbos. Each person has their own minagim וכולי. But we're gonna look at Shabbos divided by 11 different זמנים. א', ההכנה של כל השבוע לשבת עד הרגע שנכנסים לבית המדרש למנחה בערב שבת. So one time aspect is basically, it's a pretty long one.
Right.
It's from Motzei Shabbat until you go into Shul. That's one time zone.
He's talking about Mincha Gadol, or he's talking about right before Shkia?
No, probably right before Shkia. Based on this, right? Because he wouldn't. Because if it was Mincha, because if it wasn't, he'd say, okay, the next man is then when you go home afterwards and those hours of insanity.
I should learn.
That's what he said.
Because you go to Shul at 1:15. I think Avi's the only one that does that here. But you daven. But you daven. No, you still daven. Yeah, you always did. You also did it.
I did.
Okay, Bet, the second time of Shabbos. מי שנכנס לבית המדרש בערב שבת עד שיוצאים מלווים בהילג המלאכים. Those that zman that you're going to shul Friday night and you come and walk home escorted with the angels. You know, Shalom Aleichem, Malach Yashar. Each person that walks home from shul on Shabbos, he has two angels escorting him. גימל, מהרגע שיוצאים מבית המדרש, ההכנה לקידוש והקידוש עד אחר הכזית הראשון בהסעודה. Okay, I don't know what the difference is between... Three is I left the Beis Midrash. I'm preparing for Kiddush.
You're home.
I'm not home yet. I'm leaving Shul.
The second one from that is from when I
until you have the
first right. Nachon. Third one is I'm coming. I'm leaving Shul. I'm preparing Kiddush and Kiddush until the first bite I take of the Seudah.
You know, all the kids are saying I don't want to sit there.
Not in my house. By us, there's absolute right?
Peace.
Dina?
Serenity.
Actually, I don't even realize there's anyone in the room. I'm just looking at angels the whole time. Oh my gosh. Amazing. What is man? No, but like, this is why we're here. We're not here to talk about, there's avodah. it's a moment to elevate the way you know we look at things.
We said but they referred to tibat noach before.
Yeah.
It wasn't like his minucha. It wasn't like from my understanding. It wasn't like noach was like kicking back for
working.
While he was feeding
business.
It was very busy, you know. So even this table that we have for Shabbos is not a.
But that's the point that even that if the hachana is karaui, that I can be busy with avodot and they don't wear me down like during the week. The avodah that I do generally wears me down. It's an avodah that actually, like you were talking about, gives me adrenaline. It's a different type of avodah. So it's a different concept of menucha also. Like my brother told me when he was in yeshiva, I'll never forget this, when he was in. It's one of his yeshivas. He said to me, he realized how special Shabbos is from the most disgusting statements he heard from a young married bachur in yeshiva. He said, what? He said, he came to shul the next morning, and it was a winter Shabbos in the East Coast. You're talking Shabbos comes in
four.
The guy did a cheshbon. He said he was able to pound out everything. He was in bed by 7:30. And he felt that it was a hatzlacha. You understand? He went to shul. He did the sudot. He probably even threw in a dvar Torah. And it was a sheifa to be in bed by 7:30 and wake up by God. I don't know what time. Okay, he's in baya. But that's not the menucha. So he didn't do anything necessarily wrong. I would kind of give anything. I mean, but that's not the menucha. Like you're just saying, that's not the menucha. You don't feel rested after that. You don't. Not real rested. You get more tired. Shena mavi shena. What'd you think?
Spiritual.
Yeah. Okay. Dalit sudat halaya dechakal tapuchin kadishin, which we'll speak about. The Friday night meal. The fifth zman of Shabbos. Leil Shabbos Kodesh meachara suda ad. $20, guys. What's the word?
Fartags.
Huh? Fartags. What's fartags?
Is that breakfast?
No, no, morning.
No, I would say, yeah.
Morning. Yeah, up. When you get up. Vav, ha-helege fartags.
I'm pretty sure it's some, like,
cereal?
It's like regular. Is it
just cereal?
It's regular.
Google says it's Friday.
He says he's right. He says here Shabbos lifnut boker, meaning dawn. Like what does it say? It's Friday.
It's coffee.
I don't know. That makes sense.
What does yours say? Also, okay. I had a good fight.
Google translate for Yiddish.
Yeah, sure.
I had no idea.
Yeah.
Okay, guys. Six is Shabbos lifnut boker. Seven shachris al kol prateh v'chalakeh kriyat Torah musaf. What a big avoda! Oh my God. Chet, Sudat Hayom, Datiga Kadisha, lunch. Tet, Hazman Shemeachara Suda Ve'ad Mincha, which we know that with little kids, summer Shabbos is big nisyonot. Yud, Hazman Shu Bibchina Masuyemet Hashpitz Shel Kol HaShabbos Kodesh, Harava Deravin, Mincha Sha'ashuris Betosefet Shabbat. So I feel like this is a nekuda. This is, for some reason, this zman got gypped most in the modern era. I don't know why. Most of us didn't even grow up with Shal HaShuris. Only if you went to a Rebbe, you had a Chassid. But who went to Shal HaShuris is the old gefilte fish chevre in shul. It wasn't at homes. People don't do Shal HaShuris.
In shul, people stay and learn, and it's like can never go downstairs and have a
laugh. It's not an inyan. Now there is a reason for why that seuda is looked at differently, but the zman of Rava Derav and the zman of Shal HaShuris is bichlal for Nebuch. And Tosefet Shabbos, meaning, listen.
Let's get back to it.
Well, I mean, I never make it to a minyan on Motzei Shabbos.
That's what I'm saying.
Ever, because there's no minyan here. The minyanim around here start 3 minutes before, 5 minutes before Shabbos ends.
We don't run minyan.
You get up. No, but hopefully Bezrat Hashem in our shul there'll be an we're gonna have an option for regular zman and there'll be an option for Rabbeinu Tam, whatever it is. Yud Aleph, okay, the last zman, hazman shemiyad achar.
Are you gonna have a fartag zman?
A fart, yeah. Yeah, you know who the gabbai is? Rafi Ice and Toby Krem. Yesh kvar, yesh, we're having ashkama.
Yeah.
Be'elef achuz. Absolutely.
What's the significance of
Yudala? Okay, so he's going to speak about this. Is interesting. Asman shemiyad achar tzeit Shabbat. Listen, I think it's like this. What's the significance of 11? I'll tell you. I had a Rav on Kita Zayin I learned in Mechina, Midrashiyat Noam in Kfar Saba. I had a Rav there. So you see how sometimes you remember certain things, like because it touches your neshama. I spoke earlier in the week about Rav Trapp, my Rabbi Trapper, when I was in third grade. And now I'm going to talk about Rav Pniel. His name was Rav Pniel. Rav Pniel. Short, Zisa Yid. And he basically, the second the ring went on, he ripped us one time. He said, do you know what it looks like? He says, I don't really care how much you're in shiur with me or not with me. But what kills me is that when the bell goes off, the dash you have to leave Torah to go and play soccer kills me. Kills me. And it did such an inyan to us that, like, every time the bell went on after that, even if it wasn't his shiur, it wasn't a dash out to go out and play soccer. Because you can't show a meeting, I mean, we were a 13-year-old guy, like, but he still had a big inyan with us. So I think, Sash, I think it could be, like, listen, Reb Shlomo said like this, are you a 3-star Jew or not? I said, what does that mean? He's like, you ever go out on a date with a girl? And they tell, and like, you're told in Shidduchim, you know, the proper time, enough time to spend with the girl is you have at least have to have 20 minutes in the lobby of the hotel. Or I don't know what it, whatever it was. Baruch Hashem, that was one thing I was spared from. No, lobby Shidduchim.
And you show up on the date and you ask, what time is this ending?
No, you don't ask, but you're looking at the time and saying, Avar maspik zman or lo? Am I yotze, the zman date or not, right? Saying she's not your zivug, and if she ends up in the chuppah with you, you're I feel bad for her. But we do that with Shabbos. Do we start? Is it out yet? Now, of course, some people, they have to go to the airport. We're not talking about inyanim like that. But in general, I think what he's going to say is that if I can elevate the way I look at the Yud Aleph, Hazman shmiyad achar tzeit Shabbat, kulam yarvichu. You know what I mean?
Interesting, doesn't say more of Malka.
Yet. Right. Then maybe it's included in Yud Aleph. He'll explain. I don't know.
It's the way you leave. This week's daf was about the Kohen Gadol's avodah how he would leave. Are you walking out backwards or are you making a dash to the door?
I thought, I was at the Kotel last week for the first time in a long time. And I thought I was the only one in the world that still walks backwards when you leave.
Bichlano.
There were tons of people that were walking back. Yeah. I thought, I wasn't there for so long. But when I was a kid, that was like the significance of, it wasn't only how you got to the Kotel and what you did at the Kotel, it was how you walked backwards. You know, there's a story about the Rebbe. His mother noticed something weird about him. You ever see this story? He used to visit her all the time. I think every day when she was alive. And every time when he would leave, I saw them when I was in Australia, they in Chabad houses, on Motzei Shabbos, right after Avdala, a huge, you ever see this? A huge screen gets pulled out of somewhere, and they watch a video of the Rebbe. You saw this? So this was the Rebbe video I saw in Melbourne by Gutnick's shul. The mother of the Rebbe said, the most interesting thing, it was so beautiful how much when he came to visit me in the Kavod, it felt so special. But what touched me the most was the game he played when he left. They said, what do you mean? He said, whenever he left, he like walked in this really weird way, pretending that he was misadering pictures on the wall or putting things in place, but really he just didn't want to give me his back. So the way he walked out of the house was like this weird way. And she said, that was the most, you know, the way he left. So that's a very big inyan too. Very big inyan too. וננסה לדבר בעזרת השם יתברך על פי יוד א' זמנים אלו, איך לבנות על ידם את התיבה, שיהיה באופן של בו אתה וכל ביתך אל התיבה. We're going to try, we're going to do our best to
he's saying this yud alef zmanim
is the way you build the teva. Like if I can take each one of these zmanim,
know how to put it in right.
Well, I mean, you have the lingo for it, but much better.
How to engineer it.
How
to, we're talking about like, all the details.
Yeah.
So that requires
beforehand, you need the plans. So if you attack each 11 and you look, think about, and you strategize for each 11, you can't just show up and say, okay, there's this block of time, which is Shabbos.
You need the plans, but
not just the plans, you need to also have the skill. You need to hone the skill
of each specific trade.
This is what it is. Okay, we're going to do just a bit more. והאופן שאנחנו עושים זאת עכשיו, זה על ידי ההתקשרות וההידבקות. ונזכווייקן. בדברי צדיקי הדורות צריכים לגן עלינו. The way we're doing it now, the way we're going to attempt to do it now, is by gathering together and medabek to the tzaddikim of the previous generations. Al yedei hitasfut chaverim beyachad. Ubifrat be'erev Shabbat Kodesh achar chatzot. So I was wondering if we should even learn this, because he describes the timing, and I don't know if I would tell you guys, listen, or I don't even tell you guys. I don't think I could have the chutzpah to demand it in my house or anywhere, or tell my wife, listen, from now on Friday afternoon, right after Mincha Gedola, right, that's when we're going to start, the Chevra is going to get together, the Chabura is going to start. But maybe he's talking to Bachrim. They're Choliot, you know, maybe he's talking to the Bachrim, and they're like, what do they have to do? You know, I learned that in the yeshiva in Chevron, when it was in Chevron, right, Slabotka, when it was still in Chevron, and they were massacred there in 1929. There was one Talmud there. He got killed Erev Shabbos, Friday afternoon. That's when they did it. He was sitting and learning his brain. Huh? In the Beis Midrash. He was sitting and learning his brains out. They nailed him in there. I have this image of Friday afternoon learning this yid that got shechted there. What's a famous story about him? Yeah. Al yedei hitasfut chaverim biyachad, bifrat be'erev Shabbos Kodesh, achar chatzot hu mesugal biyoter, umikarei ofanim liskot lechon olam. So, on a time level, just like when those that go to the mikveh try to go after chatzot, because it's a zman that's most mesugal, and to learn this stuff also is most mesugal, Friday after chatzot, at least we're doing ishtadlut and doing it now. And then he was talking about Parashat Vayakel here. Bifat b'shavizo, shebazor hakadosh al ha-parasha, meir lanu rishon b'ayukha yesod zeh. Vita mitzadikim shema shenichlak, azor hakadosh al pi parashiyot, yesh hayachut ben ha-inanim ubuarim b'chol parasha, lezor ha-parasha inyan ha-vayakel. Raza de Shabbos, chevraya. What's the secret of Shabbos? Vayakel, chevraya, getting together. Hakoch gadol shel kibbutz chaverim yachad. The strength of friends coming together, mitoch hishtokekut v'achana, when we come together and we long to prepare, ubifrat b'acharit hayamim kfi sheYaakov Avinu alav haShalom amar l'shivtei evka he'asfu v'agid alachem, just like Yaakov Avinu told the Shvatim, come together and I will tell you, kfi shemevayer haShfat emet sheal yedei hakeilat Yaakov mamshichim et hakoach shel Yaakov Avinu alav haShalom shel hanachala bli mitzarim. Sfasemet says, by the gathering together in the Zchut of Yaakov Avinu, this concept of a nachala bli mitzarim, an inheritance that knows no ends, which is what Shabbos is all about, comes to life. And he continues here, he says, Vayakel gimatria mikveh. That's pretty special. I'm not going to pull one of those yeshivish things and now test to see if he's right. I hate. You know, those guys, they learn Balat Torah. They're not learning Balat Torah. They're sitting with their machshavon to check to see the Balat Torah. Yeah, I did that twice with Rabbi Yitzchak Ginsburg in his shiurim. My mind got so, because he does averages and algebra into the gematrias. Just take their word for it. Vayakel, okay? Vayakel is gematria mikva. Achida mishmerti tamar hayudi hakadosh sfit hagin ve'od habchina shel asefatan metaratan. Just coming together to learn about these things, bichlal, is poel something in the world. Vayinu kfi sheyita bazor hakadosh kan umevua mitzadikim suschen elinu, v'shtei ha-shabbatot shebikra shabbat d'chkit yisa v'shabbat d'vayakel. So this is very important. There's two shabbatot that explain the mahalach of what we're going to be doing. Kit yisa and vayakel. The Slonimer, you probably saw this, Dov, and the first teaching in Vayakel explains like this. What's the last thing we were told before Chet HaEgel? The last mitzvah we were told before Chet HaEgel. It's about Shabbos in Parashat Kitisa. What's the first thing we're told in Parashat Vayakel?
Shabbat.
There's Shabbos before the sin, and there's Shabbos after the sin. That we're basically going to be learning it like this. It's not stam. And he says over here, after en mugdam mocher
b'Torah, it's true. Did Kitisa happen before Vayakel or not? It's irrelevant because we have the way the Torah is presented
before us. That's what we have to work with. And the way it's presented before us is there was a Shabbos that we were told before Chet HaEgel, and right after Chet HaEgel, Hashem goes back to Shabbos,
and that parsha is called Vayakel.
אף שאין מוקדם מאוחר בתורה, third line, אך מורה על שתי בחינות והשגות השבת. There are two השגות of שבת. השבת שלפני הנפילה די העגל, והשבת שאחרי. והעצה והכוח של ויקל הוא התארה והדרך לזכות לשבת גם על אחרי הנפילה, מקווה של מים ומקווה של אש, אחד מדליק את השני. This is beautiful. There's two בחינות of mikvah, hot water and cold water. The cold water, he's basically saying, you got to jump into a mikvah. But what's the hot water? He's saying when a yid, when we're together and we turn each other on, push each other. And that's a mikvah shel ish. Echad madlik et ha-sheni. Shemoshe Rabbeinu mamshich lanu or ze la'akil keilot, v'yadei ze lamshich et kedushat ha-shabbat. V'lachem, gam dibarnu lishtadel itchazek b'inyan ha-chaburot, sheyitasfu lechol ha-pam, lechol ha-pachot pam b'shavu avor ze ha-tchil. Avor ze ha-tachlit. See where my mind is. V'yadei ze zochim l'matana tova. When you get together, for the purpose of what, and for this purpose, you receive a gift. You know what the gift is? V'zeu ha-lech ve-hodi-em. You know what those two words come from? Lech ve-hodi-em. That's Hashem telling Moshe Rabbeinu, go and tell them about Shabbos. Avi, ma pasuk shem, tazocher? Lech ve-hodi-em. Forget, but that's the inyan of Hashem telling Moshe Rabbeinu, go and tell them about Shabbos. And every time we get together, we're creating a vessel for Moshe Rabbeinu to come and say, oh, you guys want to know. Okay, you want to know, because that's why you're gathering. That's the purpose you're gathering. Moshe Rabbeinu is going to come and tell you. Sha'adei ha'etza shel Moshe Rabbeinu zuchim lematana be'ofen shel hodi'em. Da'at hitkashrut itchabrut. Da'at tahara. Ve'al ze omen b'shabbat yismach Moshe matnat chelko. Shezeu tfilah. Sha'anu mevakshim shenizkeh be'emet lenatzel et hazchiyah. הזאת שניתנה לנו, משה רבינו gives us something. We want to take advantage of what משה רבינו gave us. ועד איזה משה רבינו ישמח במתנה שנתן לנו. This is beautiful. It says every Shabbos morning, ישמח משה במתנת חלקו. משה רבינו will rejoice with what he gave us. He sees that we're taking advantage of the gift that he gave us, which was Shabbos, בראותו שאכן השכלנו לקנותה כדבעים. Every time Moshe Rabbeinu sees, like, we're taking advantage, he's like, he gives Moshe Rabbeinu simcha kivyachol. Okay, we're going to stop here. And yeah, we're going to try, b'emet, half hour. We'll limit to half hours Friday mornings. Whoever would like a sefer, let me know, and I will see how we can make a purchase. And it should give us a b'emet, a zgula for all the things we want, which is a Shabbos dika life, a Shabbos dika home.
Okay.